All right, thank you so much, Harry. Again, I just want to go ahead and introduce this to you. This is the Evaluation and Management Coding for Behavioral Health Providers, Maximize Reimbursement While Also Remain Compliant. As Harry told you, my name is Dr. Dreema Sloan Kelly. I like to tell people that I'm a weirdo kind of doc. I hope everybody needs to mute their phones, please, because you can hear some background noise. So I want to make sure that everybody's able to hear correctly. But my name is Dr. Dreema Sloan Kelly. I'm a physician as well as a certified coder. So I like to tell people that I am a weirdo kind of doc, and I like to be able to combine the medical side, the clinical side, with the billing and coding side to kind of help both sides be able to communicate a little bit better. I am president of what I call now Dr. Sloan Kelly Consulting. I switched it over a little bit. It was Kelly Sloan Associates, and January 1st we're switching over to Dr. Sloan Kelly Consulting. You can visit me on the web at www.drsloankelly.com, and also my email address is right here, and I try to remind you guys about my email address when we get to the end in case you have any questions after this is over and we don't have time to ask it during the webinar. My email address is dreema@drsloankelly.com. Usually it takes me a couple of days to respond. My assistant will get a hold of it for me, and then I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. So let's go ahead and get through some of the business matters, and then we will go ahead and get onto the topic at hand. You will be instructed by the operator or myself when it is time to ask questions. This is going to occur at the end of the webinar. So what I usually tell people to do is when a question, this is my little mantra, this is what I do when I'm listening to webinars so I can like pay attention. When a question pops in your mind, I tell people just to jot it down. Don't sit there and think about it the whole time. Jot it down on a piece of paper. Continue to listen to the webinar. 9 out of 10, your question probably will be answered by the time we're at the close of the webinar. However, there are going to be times you're going to have the question and it's still going to be there. So when you still have that question, when we get to the end of the webinar, you will be able to type in your question to me, and I will be able to answer that question live. But like I said, if you find yourself in a situation where you want to be able to, just email me the question, that's absolutely fine as well. So are you ready for some fun? I like to put this slide in here to give you a little bit about, tell you a little bit about myself and my style and what to expect for the next hour. One thing that I can definitely tell you is that I'm in a really good mood right now. Just got back from the Dominican Republic, so I was feeling really kind of sick yesterday. That's probably why I was feeling sick, but I went to the DR for Thanksgiving, so I'm feeling a little rested. So hopefully we will have a lot of fun because this is one of my favorite topics. We have a lot of slides to cover today. There are going to be parts that are feeling like it is going pretty quickly. Those are the areas that I think that you already probably are solid with. And then there are going to be areas that you're going to see that I'm going to reiterate some of the same things over and over again, especially when it comes to documentation. When it comes to behavioral health, when it comes to evaluation and management, this is usually the one area where things are confused. So you want to make sure that when the nuances where I think that there are things that I want you to pay attention to, I will make sure that you have that information. The next thing is that I put a little, at the end, I put in some question and answers for some common questions that pop up when it comes to behavioral health and evaluation and management. So hopefully those will be helpful to you as well. I will be going directly along with the slides in your handout, and I do not deviate from those. I'll probably add some information, but as I go along, you will be able to follow with your slides as well. So just as an overview, let's look at the overview slide. There have been significant changes that have taken place in behavioral health since 2013. And actually, after I started looking at what's coming down the pike for 2018, that trend is going to continue for psych. I think because there's such a big push when it comes to mental health, finally, I mean, we've been really wanting people to pay attention to this. They've been changing up the coding. Now, are we going to see that reflected in reimbursements? I'm hoping eventually. I mean, I know that, primary care did a lot of, stomping and activist work in regards to better reimbursement. I'm hoping that's going to happen on behavioral health, especially because there's so much push being put towards opioid and mental health issues. I'm hoping that with the coding changes, we'll start seeing reimbursement changes as well. But knowing what is appropriate to bill a psychiatric code and when to select an evaluation management code is important. A lot of times you want to be able to look at what the reimbursement rates are on either code so that you know which ones are more advantageous for you. When you get done with this webinar today, I think you will be able to feel pretty confident in knowing which codes to choose. Also, however, here's the big deal. When you're doing any type of coding, I don't care if it's evaluation or management or any type of procedure coding, ensuring proper clinical documentation is important. It's super important on E&Ms because for whatever reason, for evaluation and management, documentation for providers tends to be harder, or they tend to be more confused about what needs to be documented, whereas more of the regular procedure codes, since documentation requirements tend to be more straightforward. So we want to make sure that we pay attention to the documentation templates that I put across today, and also to make sure that if you are ever audited, that that does not become an issue for you. Reason